Hello, and welcome once again to our humble abode in the home of Sunshine Ministries. And I'm Gary, of course. I understand that we have new people watching. Carl, Lisa, Mary, Paul, Billy, Monica, and Randy. If you'll just excuse me for just one moment, please. Okay, now. Yeah, I guess the old man's lost his ever-loving mind, right? No. It's part of a demonstration. I know that some of you will be, you know, right on the money with this, because you have some of you have gifted with photographic memories. But what was the fourth name that I said? Does anybody know? One of you, two of you? I'm gonna guess that 95% of you didn't know. But the fourth name I said was Paul. Okay, this is my point. Where is your focus? Well, your focus was not on what I was saying, but the ridiculous headwear, or whatever you want to call it, that was on my head. That's where your focus was. And now, I just kind of wanted to slip this in, because this was really not part of the sermon that I had planned. I just want to say this: if you're looking for bad news, then you're definitely on the wrong channel. That would be CNN or Fox. Well, I had somebody tell me just the other day, someone close to me, that, watching CNN and Fox, this is good, because we know who to pray for. But my point is, why should we restrict ourselves into just what CNN or Fox or some of these news networks are displaying? My thoughts are, this entire world, not just this country, but this entire world is in need of prayer. It's a lost, dying world, and we all need prayer. I need prayer. You need prayer. See, CNN and Fox is not going to tell you about the atheist three doors down from me. Fox News is not going to tell you about the gentleman across the street that had no idea that God loved him and had an awesome plan for his life. See, CNN is not going to tell you that. Fox is not going to tell you that. So, we all need prayer. So, excuse me. Okay, let's get back into focus. We're all familiar with the old saying, you can't see the forest for the trees. Well, everyone that knows me knows that I kind of like to turn things around, and I say that you can't see the tree for the forest. Now, what I mean by that is all these, what would you call them, glamour trees, or flashy trees or whatever you want to call them, exotic. All these trees, you know, catch our attention and catch our focus, and we tend to lose focus on the tree. And the tree is Jesus. The tree, which is the true vine, the tree is the one that's standing right in the middle, strong and tall. That's where our focus needs to be. But sometimes we can't see the tree for the forest. And the forest is all these little distractions that's taking us away from the tree. I hope this is making good sense to you. This was actually inspired. Those of you familiar with Food for the Soul, that I send out, not every day, but I try to. I sent one out yesterday. It was about God's chosen ones, and I happen to be one of those. It's like we all know that Moses was a basket case, and I'm very honored, you know, to be doing God's work. As we all know, Satan has such a big mouth, and he fills our head with lies, you know. And he actually almost had me convinced not to tell you about my misfortunes. The fact is, sure, we're having our season and we're being put to the test. So, after thought, that's all the more reason to tell. The devil tried to tell me, so, well, you know, why would other people want what you have? You know, I mean, you know, we have collection agencies. We're on a first name basis, you know. And the devil's trying to tell me, well, you know, why would people want that? Well, I'm going to tell you why. The fanciest mansions, whatever, they're gone. One tornado, one earthquake, they're history. They no longer exist. Insurance? Well, you say, well, insurance will cover that. Well, I got news for you. That insurance ain't going to do you a drop of good when you're pushing daisies. You know, once all material things are gone, what will I do? What will I do? My life is over. You know, our season will soon be over. But for now, I have what no amount of money can purchase. Inner peace. Inner peace, joy, contentment, and above all, my Jesus. My Jesus died for me so that I can have all these things. And through it all, there is no storm that is big enough to take my joy away. Can't do it. No storm. So you need what I have. You need what I have. I don't have the pinstripe suit, the fancy car, you know. You need Jesus Christ, his Lord and Savior. and your best friend through thick and thin. It's what we need. And like I said, for now, I may not have that fancy car or fancy house, and maybe I never will. But I have all I need in Jesus. A little shuffling here. As we learn in Psalms 37, verse 25, I've been young and now I'm old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, or his children begging for bread. Well, I'll tell you a little secret. I didn't get this old bread basket here by begging for bread. I sure as heck ain't doing without. So where is your focus? Is it on the temporary luxuries in a rapidly dying world? Or is it where it should be? You can have permanent joy right here on this earth and thereafter if you would only just surrender to Christ. Believe me, not mocking God's work, but I had to meditate over that, and I had to talk to the Lord about it. Just to use an example for this message, that lightning that you saw, how long did you have to make a decision for Christ? How long did you have to meditate on God's Word? How long did you have to say, Lord, please forgive me of my sins as I accept you as my Lord and Savior? You didn't. Now did you? That thunder, that sound, what was that? That was you. That was you on your way to face the truth. That was you to stand before the Father. What would Jesus say about you? Because if you were ashamed of him, just like he said, he's going to be ashamed of you before the Father. And you saw that light. It's that quickly it's going to happen. So, ladies, gentlemen, young, old, this is your chance. Take it. Accept it. Receive it. Please. Give your life to Jesus right now. If you just repeat after me and sincerely mean it, from in here, Oh, Heavenly Father, I know that I have sinned against you and that my sins separate me from you. I am truly sorry. And now I want to turn away from my sinful past and turn to you for forgiveness. Please forgive me. And help me to avoid sinning again. I believe that your Son, Jesus Christ, died for my sins, that he was raised from the dead, and he is alive, and he hears my prayer. I invite Jesus to become my Savior and the Lord of my life, to rule and to reign in my heart from this day forward. Please send your Holy Spirit to help me obey you and convict me when I sin. I pledge to grow in grace and knowledge of you. My greatest purpose in life is to follow your example and to do your will the rest of my life. And it is in Jesus' name that I pray, and all of God's children said, amen and amen. You know what, folks? I love each and every one of you. And I've told you time and time again. Race, color, creed, makes no difference to me. All of you. Most importantly, Jesus don't discriminate. Jesus loves us all. Jesus loves every single one of you. There's no exclusion. He loves you all. So never think that, well, he's not going to accept me. Have mercy. If you knew my background and where I've been and that he accepted me, that would erase all doubt, my friends, my brothers, my sisters. If he saved a wretch like me, he will certainly save you. Just praying that if you said that prayer, if you didn't, replay it again and again and again. Save it. Don't believe it. You know, and Satan is going to try his best to get you to ignore this message. Don't you dare let him. He's a spineless jellyfish and he's a liar. Will life's problems disappear? No, they won't. See, the difference is that only now you don't have to deal with them alone anymore. You have the promise. You have the truth, the way, and the life to see you through it all. And his name is Jesus Christ. I love you all. And may God bless your day so ever richly. And I will see you next time. Praise God.